Hi there, this is David, and welcome to a special bonus episode of Let's Play The Legend of Heroes Trails of Cold Steel 3. Before we get started on all of the summer bonding events that we have here, let me just go over how this episode is going to work. Essentially, there are 5 different events that you can participate in, which will increase your bonding with your various characters. The one here on Vanquire Street is a Mishi event. The one on Dreykul's Plaza is a tram ride event. Vesta Street, it is baking bread. Saint District, it's a bazaar held by Elise and Alfin. And on the race course, you can actually do a timed trial race. Now, in order to go to these events, basically you have to use a ticket, and you start off with 7 tickets. Each event costs 1 of these tickets, and there's only certain people who can go to each event. It will always be the members of Class 7, Unikurt, Altina, Musée, and Ash, who can go to every single event. Then the members of Old Class 7 will kind of be mixed up in there. Each time that you go to an event, you will gain 1/2 of a star for each character. If you go to an event and you're at 4.5 stars, and then it will bring you up to, you know, the 5th star and make it orange, then you'll get a special bonding event with that character. Whenever you get that special bonding event, Reen's strength as well as art attack power will go up by 2, and the character's strength and art attack power will go up by 15. So you definitely want to make sure that you get that special bonding event at least with the characters of New Class 7. You cannot get the, any kind of special bonding, events with Claire, Sharon, or Celine. However, you can get accessories from them. You can get special bonding events with Elise and Alfin, as well as accessories with them as well. So do try to also get those accessories if at all possible, because they do come in very, very handy. Now, with all that being said and done, as far as this episode is going to go, basically I'm going to be going through each and every event, but the thing is, the events are very formulaic. So what's going to happen is, I'm going to be following Yuna's event for the most part, because she always comes up first, and then as you're going through the event, there's going to be dialogue options, and I'm going to splice in everybody's dialogue at that one point. That way we can see the events much quicker. You'll be able to go through all these events and see all the different changes in roughly 40 minutes, rather than about 4 hours that it would take if you just watched everybody's event individually. So I am doing this just to save you a lot of time, because watching all these events with all the extraneous stuff that goes on that doesn't really add to anything is, to me, pretty much a waste of time. So all 5 events and everybody's dialogue is in this episode. Hope that you guys enjoy it, and have a good day.
Thank you. All right, let's go. Let's go!
There.
Yeah!
There.
Yeah!
There.
Not bad at all.
Good luck.
Understood. Let's get riding. It's mine. Here I go. It's mine. Giddy up. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Giddy up. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Not bad.
Thank you.